something out of the ordinary, like open mouths and eye and ear rotations and whisker attitudes and all that. I do it because I really enjoy doing that stuff and putting the extra work into it. But I also know that at the same time, I'm taking a chance, if I'm doing this for competition, of all the extra work for possibly very little, if any, gain. So keep that in mind, but do it for yourself and enjoy it. When I'm working on a competition piece, I usually do something that has some meaning to me. It's one of my own trophies or something. So the amount of hours that I put into it will, I guess, in the long run, mean something to me also. Because very seldom are you going to do a competition piece that every judge or judges in a show are going to fall in love with. So most of the time you need to really enjoy this piece when you take it back home. When I'm working on commercial pieces or producing a new line or style of form, my constant effort is to create a form that's easier for my customers to mount on and that will look better. It's that much closer to a competition piece. When I walk into a showroom at a competition, I see, you know, other people using my forms. I don't want to see basic anatomy mistakes on there, so I'm constantly studying things and trying to improve these forms to get them that much closer to a competition style form, you might say. I think the locomotion and balance that you create on a wall piece is just as important as a 3D piece or pedestal piece. I like to check everything all the way around as much as I possibly can. So, like I say, even if it's a wall piece, you won't end up with something that looks a little bit awkward, but you just can't really put your finger on why. So.